Students, welcome back to our practical English program. Congratulations, this is gonna be your last chapter. Last time we talked about the British royal family. That was a very exciting experience for the people in the whole world. But today, our last chapter, we are going to discuss about 2011 disaster in Japan.It was a miserable time for Japanese and also for the world. And we have a similar experiences, maybe back to 10 or 11 years ago for 9/21. At that time, I was abroad in Canada with my two kids. So fortunately, we didn't experience that horrible experience. And today, I have anothermore experienced panelist with me, a great teacher, Irene Tsai. Welcome, Irene.
Yeah, thank you for inviting me to come over.
It's always our great pleasure to have you here. Hope that you can share more knowledge about earthquake and tsunami to us.
It's so horrible, such a disaster.
Yeah, that's right. So I think you have watched the news on that is March 11th, right? Friday. Mm-hmm. And how did you feel at that time?
I feel just so horrible. I've never seen like that. The tsunami, especially the tsunami, just like a wild war. It just rush and the cars, just like a toys floating on the water. Mm-hmm. And the buildings all collapsed. You can never forget that.
Yeah, that's true. That was a very frightening scene to the world, actually. Mm-hmm. And is there any differences between this one and our 9/21 earthquake in Gigi?
Compared to the earthquake happened in Taiwan back 10 years ago,
yes,
the magnitude is...lower in Taiwan,
yes,
means that it was not so serious.
Yeah.
However, it was so horrible in Taiwan too.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the roads, almost all, many of the roads just bombed up,
yes,
and some bridge just crush,
yes,
and many buildings fall down. That's such a living hell.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
So you didn't sleep in your room until
for a few days we slept on the playground of a school.
That's right.
Yeah, just sleep outside. Nobody dared to go inside the room and sleep on the bed.
That's right. And I feel so bad because I tried to call you, call our family, call my friends from Canada.
Mm-hmm.
But all of the communications were down, were broken because of the earthquake.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't reach any one of them.And it made me very, very worried.
Yes.
And I watched the TV sent from the satellite, and I was just, I feel so miserable for the Taiwanese victims, for my hometown, for the people who were suffering. So, yeah, really, compared to the Mother Nature, human beings are just so tiny.
Yeah.
And so helpless.
Mm-hmm.
So we should save our environment. We should be good to our Earth because we only have one planet. And now we still want to use this news as a dialoguing materials for our students to practice your daily English. So now let's take a look at the first paragraph. Did you see the miserable disaster that happened in Japan recently?
你有看到最近发生在日本的悲惨的大灾难吗？
Sure, who didn't?
当然啦，谁没有看到呢？
On March 11,
在3月11号，
a magnitude 9.1 earthquake struck Japan.
一个规模 9.1 级的地震袭击日本。
It was Japan's worst recorded quake.
那是日本史上有记录以来最严重的地震。
Over the next hour,
在随后的一个小时之内，
another 6 aftershocks rocked the area.
在同一地区又发生了六次余震。
The ensuing tsunami,
随之而来的海啸，
a terrible 30-foot wall of ocean rushed to the coast at 500 miles per hour.
30英尺高的海啸水墙以每小时500英里的速度冲击海岸。
Students, here we have the Richter magnitude scale for earthquake. The worst one in the history was in 1960. It happened in Chile. That was 9.5. And it was just a great disaster. And the second one was 2004.In India, caused the southeast tsunami, and that's the last hundreds, thousands of people just died at that time. And this time, magnitude 9.1 struck Japan. Also, this is the worst earthquake in Japan. Irene, do you think that can we see some signs if the tsunami is coming?
Tsunami, it always happens after earthquake.
Yes, only the 6.5 earthquake can occur, can tsunami. Cause the tsunami. Uh-huh. Yes, so be careful if the earthquake magnitude is above 6.5, so be careful of the tsunami. Mm. And there are several signs that you can see the tsunami is coming. Mm-hmm. One is that the waves...will withdraw very quickly. Mm. And don't try to catch the fish left on the sand, okay? You just run away to the opposite side. Mm-hmm. Because it withdraws so quickly, it means that another big wave will come up pretty soon. Mm-hmm. And also the elephant can hear the sound of a tsunami. Mm. So in Thailand, some of the elephants, they knew it. Then they ran from the opposite directions.Then they save lots of tourists. Mm. So it's just to be observant to the nature. Mm-hmm. It might save your life.
Yep.
Now let's take a look at the vocabulary. First one, disaster, noun.
名词，灾害，灾难，不幸。
We were all shocked by the disaster of the Japanese earthquake.
这场日本地震大灾难让我们所有人大为震惊。
Number two, miserable, adjective.
形容词，痛苦的，不幸的。
Shelley has a very miserable marriage.
雪莉的婚姻很痛苦。
We have some special terms for you. The first one, magnitude.
地震级数。
Second one, tsunami.
海啸。
Number three, 500 miles per hour.
每小时500英里。
Students, tsunami is a word.Derived from Japanese language, and the English adapted. 这个 tsunami 这个字是源自于日语的。Okay, we will talk more later. Let's take a break. Students, welcome back. Now we want to see more details.Of the disaster. Let's take a look at the paragraph 2. On TV, we saw cars floating in the water like toys.
在电视上，我们看到汽车像玩具一样漂浮在水上。
Boats were crashed under bridges.
船只撞毁在桥下。
Homes were destroyed to rubble.
家园被摧毁成为瓦烁。
Many buildings were on fire.
很多建筑物着火。
That was so terrifying.
好恐怖。
It was just like a living hell.
那就像是人间炼狱。
So many people died instantly.
很多人当场毙命。
Those unfortunate refugees,
那些不幸的幸存者,
torturously watched the water take away their homes, their workplaces, and their beloved ones.
痛苦地看着大水冲走他们的家园、工作场所和挚爱的家人。
Everything was gone in such a short time.
一切都在瞬间消失了。
Even now I read this part, I feel so sad, so miserable for them. You know, the reporters say that some of the victims, even if they could escape from the water, they couldn't escape from the fire. 天地之大竟然没有容身之处。That's really, really miserable.Okay, let's take a look at the vocabulary. Number three, float. Verb.
不及物动词，漂浮，浮动。
Those cars were floating on the water.
那些车子在水上漂浮。
Number four, refugee.
名词，难民，流亡者。
Many refugees came from Mexico to America.
很多难民从墨西哥来到美国。
Number five, torturously, adverb.
副词，折磨人的，充满痛苦的。
Edward is torturously watching his father's illness.
爱德华很痛苦地看着他父亲生病。
Students, we knew that Japanese were suffering so much because of the earthquake, tsunami, and worst of all,There was another great disaster approaching. Let's take a look at the paragraph 3. And another disaster was coming.
另外一个灾难又开始了。
Japan declared an emergency at the nuclear power plant facilities in Sendai 6 hours after the earthquake.
在地震后六小时，日本宣布福岛核能发电厂发生紧急意外。
They asked for help from other countries.
他们寻求其他国家的援助。
We saw the fires in the plants.
我们看到核能发电厂先是着火。
And then the explosions.
然后爆炸了。
It caused a big alarm for the whole world.
它造成全世界极大的警觉。
Because of the possible exposure to radiation.
因为大家都担心可能发生的核能外泄。
It was a truly frightening moment for the whole world.
这对全世界来说是一个非常令人害怕的时刻。
Students, let's take a look at this paragraph. Another emergency occurred. That is a nuclear power plant facilities, failure. Plant here doesn't mean 植物。Here means factory. And Japanese authorities, they asked for help from other countries. It even scared us more because it means that things is not controlled by their hand. So they need help. And actually, the American troops sent a marine troop to the Japan coast to help out.And we talk about the explosions and the radiation. Why everybody was so frightened at that moment? What the radiation can damage our body? Can you tell some of the symptoms?
Yeah, the radiation is such a harmful element for people.
Yes.
People will get cancers after they have been radiated.
Yes, or maybe they die.
Instantly.
Yeah, maybe they die instantly. If they don't die, then they just get injured. Then they would have that cancer.
Yeah, a few years later, they might die too.
That's right. And also their children, their reproduction, they will be abnormal.
And the radiation will go through the air, so spread very largely.
Yes, through the air, through the soil, through the water.
Yes.
It will contaminate the milk, the products, the crops,
the
everything. Yes. So that's why everybody was so frightened.
That's right.
At that time. Let's take a look at the vocabulary number 6, declare, verb.
及物动词，宣布，宣告。
The government declared a new policy for public health care.
这个政府宣布一项新的全民健保政策。
Number 7, facility, noun.
名词，设备，设施。
What kind of facilities do you have in your new hotel?
在你的新旅馆里面有什么新的设备
？Number 8, explosion, noun,
名词，爆发，爆炸。
There was a terrible explosion at the firework factory.
在那家爆竹工厂发生了一起可怕的爆炸事故。
Number 9, radiation, noun,
名词，辐射能，放射线。
People have to wear special clothes to avoid the harmful radiation.
人们必须穿着特别的服装以避免有害的放射物。
We have a special term here for you, students. That is a nuclear power plant.
核能电厂。
And now let's take a look at paragraph 4 to know more about the details of how did they deal with this crisis. The next one.The authorities explained.
有关单位解释说
，The backup diesel generators used to power cooling systems had failed.
用来提供冷却系统电力的备用柴油发电机故障了。
There were fears of partial meltdowns.
他们担心部分核能电厂反应炉熔毁。
And exposed fuel rods.
和核能电厂核心的暴露。
Then they started to evacuate residents.
随后他们开始撤离居民。
Thousands of residents had been evacuated.
成千的居民被撤离。
About 180 highly trained nuclear operators had stayed behind.
大约180位受过良好训练的专家留守。
Trying to fix the problem.
试着解决这个问题。
Even though they knew it might mean serious illness or death by radiation,
即使他们知道辐射可能导致重大疾病或致死
they are truly heroes.
他们真是英雄啊
To sacrifice themselves to save the country and the world.
因为他们愿意牺牲自己的性命救日本救全世界
Yes.We talk about the evacuation. Actually, some foreign countries, they evacuate their residents more far away than the Japanese have evacuated their residents. It means that the foreign countries saw this crisis more serious than the Japanese authorities. And we talk about the truly heroes here. What do you think of those truly heroes?
I really admire their spirit.
Yes.
They want to even sacrifice their own life to do something, to save somebody's life.
That's right. And because of them, they really saved the world. They fixed the problem. Okay, let's take a break. Students, let's take a look at this vocabularies. Number 10, authority, noun.
名词，官方，当局。
The authorities said 8 people died in this car accident.
当局表示有八个人死于这场车祸。
Number 11, evacuate, verb.
及物动词，撤空，撤离。
We have to evacuate 4 villages because of the flood.
由于洪水，我们必须撤空四个村子。
Number 12, resident, noun.
名词， 居民、定居者。
Are you one of the residents in this new building?
你是住在这栋新大楼的居民吗？
Let's take a look at the phrase used to.
过去曾经做，而现在已经不再这么做了。
I used to go swimming every morning.
我过去每天早上游泳。
Now we have some special terms for you. Backup diesel generator.
备用柴油发电机。
Cooling system.
冷却系统。
Partial meltdown.
部分核能电厂反应炉熔毁。
Exposed fuel rod.
核能电厂核心暴露。
Now students, let's take a look at the paragraph 5. To see what was going on. On Friday evening,
在周五晚上,
almost 7,000 people were dead.
几乎死了7,000人,
and more than 10,000 were missing.
超过10,000人失踪。
The officials hadn't finished counting yet.
而有关部门仍在继续统计伤亡人数。
To inspire the spirits of the Japanese,
为了要激励日本民众的精神
，Emperor Akihito addressed his country on national television.
日本天皇现身电视发表演说。
He encouraged Japan to continue putting forth its best effort to save all of the suffering people.
鼓励日本人竭尽所能救助受苦中的人们。
And applauded how his countrymen had handled the crisis.
而且赞扬日本人应变和处理危机的能力。
The world felt the same, he noted.
他说，全世界的人都有同感。
That was a very inspirational speech.
那真是一篇激励人心的演说。
On Friday evening, 这指的就是其实当天晚上。就是祖纳米发生以后的当天晚上，他说有7,000个人死亡，有10,000个人受伤不见了。那么现在到7月11号的统计呢，应该是有15,550个人是死亡的，受伤的有5,688位，然后失踪的5,344位。有715,545栋的房子被毁灭。So that's really terrible. Now let's take a look at the vocabulary. Number 13, inspire, verb.
及物动词，鼓励，鼓舞。
Ron's spread behavior inspired us so much.
荣恩勇敢的行为鼓舞了我们。
Number 14, a blow, verb.
及物动词，称赞，鼓励。
Let's applaud Gloria's courage.
让我们为 Gloria 的勇气鼓掌。
Number 15, crisis, noun.
名词，危机，紧急关头。
Crisis 的复数是 crises.同学可以看得到哈。We are facing a crisis in our business.
我们正面对事业上的危机。
Number 16, inspirational. Adjective.
形容词，鼓舞人心的。
Amanda gave us a very inspirational speech.
Amanda 给了我们一个很鼓舞人心的演讲。
Students will want to take a look at the last paragraph to see how Japanese behaved during the whole disaster. Paragraph 6. I feel the same.
我也有同感。
Even though the Japanese were suffering so much,
即使日本人遭受如此重大折磨,
they still behaved with dignity and great order.
但是他们仍然表现得很有尊严和纪律。
Their behavior impressed the whole world.
他们的行为让全世界印象深刻。
I hope they can overcome this terrible disaster as soon as possible.
我希望他们能尽快从灾难中重新站起来。
Let's donate some money to them.
让我们去捐一些钱给他们吧。
Sure, let's do it now.
当然，我们现在就去捐吧。
And here we talk about they behaved with a dignity and great order. What do you think? In what way do you see that they behaved with dignity and order?
In such a disaster, everything is in chaos.
Yes.
But nobody robbed. There's
no robbery.
No robbery. And when they were waiting for the food, they stand in line.They
That's
didn't、
true.
Cut in, so they behave in a great order.
That's right. They are very submissive and very obedient、mm-hmm. people. And they stood there standing in line in the cold weather, waiting for the drink water or food. And that was very impressive to、mm-hmm. all of the world. And the other thing I learned from the internet was that even the gangsters,、mm.They didn't do anything bad to the victims. On the contrary, they opened their warehouses for the food and drink to provide to the victims.、
Mm-hmm.
And they tried to protect the whole victims in a peace. So that's why now they become a police.、
Mm.
Okay? So I think in some way, we have to admire Japanese spirits and their dignity.And their、great order. And we salute to them for their spirit.、
Mm-hmm.
Now let's take a look at our vocabulary 17. Suffering. Adjective.
形容词受苦的受难的
So many people are suffering from food shortage in Africa.
很多非洲人正因为食物短缺而受苦
Number 18.Dignity.
Noun. 名词尊严
Mandela is a man with great dignity.
曼德拉是一位很有尊严的人
Number 19. Donate. Verb.
及物动词捐献捐赠
I donated some money to the poor.
我捐赠一些钱给穷人
Now let's take a look atOne of the most、useful phrases, as soon as possible.
尽快
Please let me know your final decision as soon as possible.
请尽快让我知道你最后的决定
Students, we have、went through all of this content already. And I know you feel the same.We always feel sympathy for the disasters of the whole world. And is there any way that we can prevent this kind of disaster? Irene, what do you think?
I think natural disaster is unavoidable.
Especially in terms of an earthquake.
Yes.
And tsunami.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
We do have some equipment to predict.When the earthquake will come,、
mm-hmm.
but not so
precise till、
yeah.
now.、
Mm-hmm.
And this time, because of the Japanese disasters, so many countries reconsider about the safety of the nuclear power plant.
That's right.
Right?、
Mm-hmm.
So it gives us a deep issue to think about. Do we really need...this kind of a nuclear power and to put everyone in the world in jeopardy.
Mm-hmm.
So that's also one of the questions. Thank you so much for being with us for 18 weeks. It's not easy to learn English, but please keep on learning it. Someday you will be very successful because of your good English ability. Thank you. Hope that we can see you next time. Goodbye.
Thank you. Bye.